Good day, students. Good morning, everyone. This is the second lecture related to class 11 physics subject. And in this lecture, today we will discuss the second part of kinematics topic, that is uniformly accelerated motion. And in this, today we will learn about the derivations of equations of motion by all the three methods. Number one, by normal method, and number two, by graphical method, and number three, that is last part, by calculus method. The calculus method is what? Very, very important and very easy concept, because in that concept there is no further complicated term. When you just learn two or three concepts, then you can derive very easily and within few steps. Just see, starting first, that is normal method. Normal method, or you say that algebraic method. Derivation of equation of motion. In case of deriving equation of motion, the concept of acceleration must be known. And when you are knowing about the concept of acceleration, then the derivation is very easy. Acceleration is what? The time rate of change of velocity. Time rate of change of velocity of an object is defined as acceleration. Let's see. First, by definition of acceleration, by definition of acceleration definition, a is equal to what? Change in velocity, final minus initial, and whenever time dividing, then time rate of change of velocity. Clear? And when time rate of change of velocity given, then acceleration concept is clear. Then after this, let's see, very interesting concept. The concept of acceleration totally depends upon velocity and time. Here, velocity change upon time, and when you by cross multiplying, then at is equal to what? V minus u, and we say that v is equal to u plus at. Clear? This is the derivation of first equation of motion. And for second, equation of motion, the concept of average speed. If the time interval is same, that is within t time, the velocity changes from v u to v, then how the total distance covered? By definition of distance, or we say that average velocity or average speed. Average speed, you got total distance upon total time, and here total distance, that is s, and total time t. So average speed into, whenever average speed upon time, that is what? Distance upon time, that is speed. So average speed, total distance upon total time, then total distance is equal to what? Average speed into time. Just see, by definition of average speed, by definition of average speed,
VAV is equal to what? Total distance. Total distance upon total time.
One thing just very very important. Average speed concept is utilized in deriving second as well as also in deriving third equation. Only one minute change in the derivation of second and third. Just see, everything will be clear. Here,
average speed is what? U plus V upon, that is 2. And total distance here S, and total time is T. Then S is equal to U plus V upon 2 into T. But we are knowing what? V is equal to U plus AT. Then S is equal to U plus, and the V value U plus AT whole upon 2 into T. That is equal to U plus U means what? 2U plus AT, and here T upon, and here 2, T into upon 2, then 2U T upon 2 plus AT square upon 2, so 2 cancel out,
then the result will be
S is equal to UT plus 1 upon 2 AT square. This is the derivation of second equation of motion.
And for third, up to this step, everything will be same.
Third, by definition of average speed, by definition of average speed, S is equal to, up to this stage, everything will be same, then S is equal to what? V plus U upon 2 into T,
V plus U upon 2 into T, but the value of T, just observe from here, the value of T is equal to what?
V minus U upon A. We use the value of T,
V minus U upon A, from first. Then this one equation becomes what?
V plus U, V minus U, and A upon 2 and A. And 2 into A, 2A,
and multiplying S, that is 2AS.
2AS is equal to what?
A plus B, A minus B, that is A square minus B square.
I will say that in simple way, V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. This is the derivation of third equation on behalf of concept of
second. First,
V is equal to U plus AT. Second, S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And third, V square is equal to U square plus 2a,
yes. All the three equations are deriving in very simple way. Just note down, after this we will derive the equations of motion by graphical method. Just note down. You see, after the derivation of equations of motion by normal method or algebraic method, the next one concept is what? That is graphical method. Very simple.
Graphical method is so simple. Graphical method.
In graphical method, only one graph is necessary to derive all the three equations.
The same here, the graph concept. This is y-axis and this is x-axis, and then
after y and x-axis, the concept of initial velocity and final velocity, just see, suppose any object is moving with initial velocity u, that is from O to A, the initial velocity u, and after time t, and after time t, its velocity becomes what? V. So velocity becomes V. Then with the help of this single graph we can derive all the equations, either first or second or third, very easy way. Only some concept when you are knowing, then you can derive the concept. It is also very easy. From B to D, the distance will be V minus U, because this one also U, because the rectangle side will be equal. And from A to B, if time taken is what? T. Time taken by the object is T, then this one will be what? Also T. The concept that is necessary to derive equations of motion, two concepts: the slope of velocity time graph, the slope of initial velocity u and final velocity v, and the slope of velocity time graph gives the concept of acceleration, and area under velocity time graph gives the concept of displacement. Just see,
first slope of velocity time graph. Slope of VT graph gives the concept of acceleration, that is A is equal to what? Acceleration here, and slope means this one value, theta is equal to slope. And this theta means what?
Just like tan theta. Tan theta means what? Perpendicular upon base.
So V minus U upon T. In a simple way, KT is equal to V minus U. Or you can say that V is equal to what? U plus KT. This is the derivation of first equation of motion. Clear?
V is equal to U plus KT. And after this, the concept of second, that is the area under velocity time graph and bounded by time axis.
So this one area, just like this one area, when we calculate this area, then we will get what? The displacement, this one, center is an area, and having a trapezium shape. Second one, Area under VT graph and bounded by time axis. Bounded by time axis
gives the concept of displacement.
Very simple concept. That is, S equal to what?
Area under this AB curve and bounded by time axis. It means area of this trapezium. Trapezium area means what? Sum of parallel side into height upon 2.
That is equal to 1 upon 2. Sum of parallel side means U plus V into height means what? T. But the value of V from first equation we are knowing what? That is U plus AT. So U plus, and further U plus KT into T, that is U plus U means what? That is 2 U plus KT into T, and when you multiply with T and dividing by 2, then we will get what? S is equal to 2 UT upon 2 plus KT square upon 2. 2 cancel out, then S is equal to UT plus 1 upon 2 at square. This is the derivation for second equation of motion. Clear? First equation, it is v equal to u plus at. Second equation, s equal to ut plus half at square. And then last one, third, also based on this concept. Area under velocity time graph. Third equation. The same concept. Area under velocity time graph. Vt graph and bounded by time axis. Bounded by time axis. Represent the displacement. Represent the displacement. So just see, s is equal to what? Same as 1 upon 2 u plus v into t. But the concept of u plus v or v plus u both having same, and the t concept. The derivative of this equation, t is equal to what? We have to use what? V minus u. Upon A, just like previous variation by normal method. Also, we have to use what T is equal to V minus U upon A. So, this one becomes 1 upon 2 V plus U, and here V minus U upon A. So, 2A whenever multiplied in S, then gives what? 2AS is equal to V square minus U square. Are in simple way v square minus u square is equal to 2a, yes, v square is equal to u square plus 2a, yes, v square is equal to u square plus 2a, yes. This is the derivation of third equation of motion. Clear? So in this way you can derive only one concept, that is graphical concept, and two further information about graph, that is slope of velocity time graph representing what? Acceleration, and area under velocity time graph representing displacement. Just note down all. After this I will explain by calculus method. You see, after the normal algebraic and graphical method, the last one that is very very important and very very easy, that is calculus method. Calculus method. Let's see what is the concept of calculus method. Or we say that integration method. Integration method. Integration method, one formula is used here. What? Integration of e x power n tx is equal to x power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. This one. If x power 2 is given, then 2 plus 1, 3 upon 3. If x power 0 is given, suppose if x power 0 dx, or only you say that x power 0 is what? Only dx is given, then x power 0 plus 1 upon 0 plus 1, that is equal to what? X. It is equal to x. So in this way we can derive first, second and third formula by the concept of acceleration and velocity definition. Let's see, first by definition of acceleration, by definition of acceleration, it is what? A equal to dv upon dt. Dv means what? Short change in velocity, and dt short change in time. Then dv is equal to a dt. And now after this, integrating both sides with respect to proper limit. Integrating both sides with respect to proper limit. We have integrating both sides with respect to proper limit. we have. Then integration from u to v, dv is equal to a integration from 0 to t dt. Clear?
And then this one, dv just like dx is equal to what? Yes, dv, that gives what?
Only v. Only v, and here u to v is equal to what? A t 0 to t. So first, I will remember putting upper limit at the place of this integrand term and then minus lower limit. So v at the place of v and then minus u is equal to what? A t minus 0. T minus 0. Then this is what? V minus u is equal to a t. V minus u is equal to
a t, or simply
v is equal to u plus a t. This is the derivation of first equation.
And for second, by definition of velocity, by definition of velocity,
by definition of velocity concept, v is equal to what? Rate of change of displacement, here dx. So dx is equal to v dt. But the value of v from first equation, that is what? U plus at. U plus at. So dx is equal to u plus at into dt. Clear?
And then after this, integrating both sides further with respect to proper limit.
Integrating both sides with respect to proper limit. Proper limit. Then it is dx x naught to x is equal to u dt 0 to t plus 0 to t a t dt. Because
here 0 to t on u plus a t dt, then after breaking this bracket, u dt plus a t dt, u dt 0 to t, and then a t dt 0 to t, then this one becomes what?
Here dx is what? X, then x naught to x, and this one equal to u t 0 to t plus, and here t means what?
Integration of t, then power 1 here, nothing is what? Given, 1 given, then 1 plus 1 upon 2.
And t power 1 plus 1 upon 2, and here a, that is outside the bracket, 0 to t.
Let's see, after this, at the place of x, x and then minus x naught is equal to
0, not 0, u inside bracket t minus 0 plus a upon 2 at the place of t square. First upper limit t and then 0 square. Then this one becomes what?
Yes, x minus x naught, if representing by s,
then s is equal to this one ut plus 1 upon 2 a t square. 1 upon 2 a t square. This is the derivation of
second. Clear? So second derivation is E, but in third derivation, very conceptual term is utilized. The concept of third derivation also based on acceleration concept, but there will be some change. And what the change? That is very important. For first of all, note down all. And then for third,
The concept of first is utilized by definition of acceleration to see A is equal to dv upon dt, and then in dv upon dt we have to multiply ds upon, multiply and divide both dv upon dt into dx upon dx. And this one, when you just forget this one term, then impossible to derive this formula by calculus method. So after this, A dv upon dx, adjusting the terms, and dx upon dt. Here dx upon dt means what? That is velocity concept. Just from this equation, v is equal to what? Dx upon dt. So this one becomes what? Dv upon dx into v. Why this one changes? Because in third equation there is no concept of time. So we are just replacing the time concept by dividing and multiplying with dx. So this one equation becomes v dv equal to a dx. Clear? After this, we have to integrate both sides with respect to proper limit. Just see, after this step, integrating both sides with respect to proper limit, and then everything will be clear. Integrating both sides. Both sides with respect to proper limit, we have, that is v dv, here u to v, initial to final, and then a dx initial to final. So this one becomes what? Here v dv changes into v means what? V square upon 2 will be integration, that is power 1, so 1 plus 1 upon 2, and here u to v, and this one becomes what? A and dx, acceleration x from x naught to x, and then at the place of v, putting v, then minus u, so v square upon 2 minus u square upon 2, and then after this, at the place of x, put x, and then minus x naught is equal to a x minus x naught. So x minus x naught means what? That is yes. So v square minus u square upon 2 is equal to a yes. By cross multiplying, v square minus u square is equal to 2a yes. Clear? And v square is equal to u square plus 2a yes. This is the derivation of third equation. So in case of deriving either first or second or third, the concept of either velocity or acceleration or slope by the graphical method and normal method, average velocity concept, if everything is clear, then you can derive. And always remember one thing more, dx upon dt is equal to v, and dv upon dt is equal to a, but v is equal to what? Dx upon dt further, so ddt, and x means, v means dx upon dt, so this one becomes what? Acceleration is equal to second order derivative, a is equal to d2x upon dt square. And another important point, that is reaction time. Reaction time is the time which a person observe things and act. And about instantaneous acceleration, I just explained in first lecture, the limiting value of average acceleration. What I will explain first, limiting value, just like a I, if instantaneous acceleration, then limit del t tends 0 del v upon del t, and this one will be what? dv upon dt. And this dv upon dt means what? A. Either ai or a dv upon dt. The concept, this a is equal to dv upon dt means what? Here, acceleration concept. Clear? So in this way, you can solve out any numerical based on either acceleration concept or displacement concept or velocity concept. If any confusion going on, then you can ask. So that's all for today. Have a nice day.